precious than the cost of anything. And we are working on the same philosophy that ki every life is very precious, and we have to see that ki how we can make the vaccine affordable to each and every person in the country. And the second guiding principle is that ki how to reach the people. Do we have the adequate infrastructure? Do we have the adequate manpower to deliver these things?
For the first time ever, probably, there's going to be a stronger demand than a supply. And we don't really know what that supply is going to look like. So you are actually going to have to prioritize individuals based on their vulnerability.
I see it from a systems perspective. India has 36 states and union territories. And literally, we have 36 health systems in the country. So I think coordination across all levels, central, state, district, sub-district, across all 36 states and union territories and the health ministry is going to be critical. To an extent, this will be decentralized, but I think the vaccine supplies are going to be centralized. But for sure, the first priority set has to be the healthcare workers, both in the public and private sector. And the government of India has announced that they will do that.
Given that, the first prioritized beneficiaries of this vaccine will be some of the healthcare workers themselves, I think, in thinking about training healthcare workers and vaccinators to deliver COVID-19 vaccine, I think given that this is happening amidst the global pandemic, first and foremost, training on infection prevention and control will be critical. And that's something that, Jipaigo has been doing since the advent of this pandemic.
One area we have not talked about is the urban area. The COVID in urban areas is going to be critical. Rural areas have a better system for immunization in the routine immunization setup. The urban areas, the A&Ms don't, they're not there. And so vaccinators, who would be the vaccinators? How would you bring the beneficiaries to the session sites? Where would you organize them? So the urban aspect would be very, very critical.
From our point of view, the private sector coming in is going to be the game changer. And what we are hearing from the initial conversations is that the government is really looking at all hands on deck, private sector being partner to the government in this whole effort. And it's going to be actually very important, because if you look at the private sector and the way they handle their distribution, there's a lot to that we could actually learn.